And look what we have here again. What a privilege and honor to have Chef Andy here from Sushi Chef Institute, Torrance, California. And some of you saw the Miami roll that he created. This is a follow-up video to that. How do you like your stay in Miami so far? Are you enjoying yourself?
Well, I can see it on nice weather. I like that so much. I just get off the ship, but I just finished the work. There's no shaking in my land. That's good for me. So I can kind of show you what I can do.
Okay.
So I'd like to show you cutting technique so you can see what we do.
Okay, let's go through some of the things you'll be cutting up.
Yeah. So we have a pineapple, and we do for something you can buy in a store. So I do that here, the pineapple, just a little cut, haircut. So we have a nice haircut.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Quality to 1/8. Sanding nicely.
Very nice.
Dragon fruits. Have a honeydew and cut and right in the middle. And we do seeds out. A lot of water in here, so we do take it out. And straight. Okay. So we're taking out the sweet area. And we do one more time. For a skewer, get the little boat, a little angle, and put it on to and back on. Do here, we have a little wave in here. Get centers out complete. You cut it by a little angle, by around 45 angle. Good. You can push in the middle. inside. Okay. This one down. To in the center. Okay, next one in the vegetables in here. Oh, this is a hard one. Repeating technique. The more classic technique, it's called katsuramuki, is peeling. Technique. As thin as you can. Just keeping a little while into jujuru. It's got a little softness I need to do. So this one old school put together, and we keep in the first one. 2, 3, good. You're starting to peel one by one. Everything in those one are old school. Cut it. Deba. This one. Good, good, good. This one only. Yeah, pretty old school.
Very pretty.
Gonna dry a little bit so we can do able to bend over. Wrapping all the way to the end. I'm refreshing a little bit of water. Another 4 hours in.
Beautiful. Again.
And a little different style and a flour. Still keeping it old school, so we do that. So this cucumber and peeling technique. Oops, sorry. Making maybe a 5 or 6 garnish techniques, making a nice and beautiful your sashimi plate, and then making people impress. So you should have some few of them. So be good. So I do cucumber backwards. Old school. Here. Cut. You can create anything you want. Easy one, everybody know. Butterflies. You can put it in here. This one's called a matsu, this everybody knows. I'm just going to push one side and pull back, push in, push back, push in, push back. Okay, this one. Yep, you can decorate to your side to look at it.
Beautiful.
And something easy and do quickly. You see the dragon fry. Hopefully.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Something gonna stay, so we gotta use cup. Something, a new version. Got a small one. And put it in here. And do cut a small one. One more time. Side to side, back on here.
Cute.
It's cute.
Yeah, very cute. I love penguins.
It likes to be something fun.
Yeah.
So those are garnishes you can do for sushi bar.
Beautiful work.
And showing to the customer, and people are very impressed with what you do. So.
Oh yeah. Now, do you do this in your? You show this to your students as well?
Yes, I do.
Oh, nice.
Students, yeah. We do have vegetable and fruit is cutting.
Yeah.
And then also we do hanan. Hanan and the bamboo leaf, cut it. This traditional one too.
Sure.
So those one is making something you have a slow time. A lot of practicing. So
yeah.
You're making practice for that.
Very nice. Thank you so much,
okay.
Chef Andy. Thank you so much for being here. What an honor. And again, his information is down below. Check out the description box. And if you have ever wanted to become a sushi chef, a real sushi chef, certified, this is a place to go.
Yes, please. Come over.
Yes. We'll see you soon. Thank you again.
Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye.